Linda Nance. I am a member of the Independent Center and have been coming to the center for over 5 years. I came to the center because I was diagnosed with depression and never went anywhere. So my caseworker signed me up from BJC, Behavioral Health, to come to the Independent Center. They accepted me with open arms, and I have been here ever since. By coming to the Independent Center, I have been able to apply myself more than I have ever done before. I have become a peer specialist, started back working part-time, and now I am getting ready for school in the spring or summer at St. Louis Community College. This year, I have been more virtually involved with Clubhouse, and I have been involved with social justice advocacy within Independent Center. I have been focusing on spending more time with friends and family because every day is not promised. I've also been focusing more and for the racial impact on members here at the Clubhouse to make our Clubhouse and world a better place. I'm also working on getting some school issues settled as well. Spending time in the conversation starts here group has helped me to understand how racism affects my mental health and what I can do to educate myself and others about it. It has helped me to understand people more, and the group is educating me on how to make things better. I think it is important that everyone watching tonight knows that we are all God's people. We should love and respect one another, and that a person with a mental illness is just as capable as a person without mental illness. Thank you for watching tonight. Please donate by voting for your favorite dancer. All of the funds you donate help people like me find belonging and independence. Have a great night. Thanks. Bye.
Welcome to the Independent Center's Champion of Champions event. Our program will begin in 2 minutes.
I dance because I believe in the Independent Center and what they do for every adult who suffers from persistent and serious mental illness.
I dance because I feel it's my responsibility to help those in need.
The reason why I want to dance is because I believe in the Clubhouse.
I dance because the Independent Center fills a vital need.
We dance because Independent Center makes a real difference in our St. Louis community.
I dance because the Independent Center provides vital services to people in need, and I want to help those people and to reach their full potential.
I dance because I love to wear white leggings and a pink tutu. And where else and when else am I going to get to wear those?
We dance.
We dance.
Because it makes us happy.
I dance because it makes me happy and I like helping others.
I dance because of all of you.
I dance because I see what Dancing with the St. Louis Stars can do for members, help members gain employment, housing, education, a boost of confidence, a peace of mind. And whatever I can do to help out my fellow members, I will.
I dance because of excitement for the Independent Center.
I dance because I love how the Independent Center helps those very deserving people with mental illness lead productive and rewarding lives.
I dance because it's a great opportunity to do something very valuable for a very worthy cause in the Independent Center.
I'm dancing this year because the mission is important for our community.
I dance for the Independent Center because I believe it is a treasure to our community.
I dance because I want to motivate you to open up your wallet to support this fabulous organization that provides so much good to our community.
I dance because I'm a supporter of the Independent Center and everybody who needs mental health support during this incredibly difficult time.
I dance because it's important to raise money for the Independent Center to continue to help people who are challenged with mental illness.
I dance because the Independent Center changes lives for the better.
I dance for the Independent Center because of what they've done for me and what they can do for you and your family, your friends, and help us get through this situation and become better together.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Jennifer Blome from KTRS, the Big 550. Weekdays at 10, you can hear me with Wendy Weiss on the Jennifer and Wendy Show, and I hope you will tune in. Well, thank you for joining us for tonight's virtual program. If you've attended Dancing with the Stars before, you know it's an evening of fun and fundraising for the Independent Center. We're thrilled to be able to bring you a virtual event this year. Now, this year, to celebrate 40 years of providing mental health services to our community, what we've done is this. We've asked past dancers to return to compete in the Champions of Champions event. So the dancers will take us back and look at their past performances, and they'll all compete to earn the top spot. In addition to the dancers and performers, we'll also speak with staff and supporters and members. And to kick things off, let's hear from some of them now, because what a year they've had.
When this pandemic hit, where Independent Center is an organization whose mission is to help adults with serious and persistent mental illness with their recovery, to return to work, to return to school, to have a reason to get up in the morning, to have purpose and belonging and connection and to be part of a community.
It was scary. There was so much uncertainty that, you know, we were just kind of from day to day wondering what was going to happen next to our clubhouse and to our members.
And I don't think any of us ever expected that we'd be dealing what we were dealing with come March 13th. And that was the day for us that it became very real. That was the day we decided it's become dangerous to be outside. We have a very vulnerable community. And it was the day we decided to, at least for our residential care facilities, to go ahead and talk about quarantine.
So once COVID hit and we told them that they were going to be quarantined following the guidelines up under DHSS, it was really hard for a lot of people to say that they can't leave out of the building. We tried to find different methods and different things for them to do to kind of cope with them being quarantined. It was really stressful in the beginning. The staff had to come together and work together as a team to make sure that we were addressing all of the needs of our residents at Newstead Place.
You know, the isolation is something that we try to break from people, and that's why we have the Independent Center. We bring people into the clubhouse so they can get on with their lives. And the difference that I've seen over the years that it's made in members' lives is incredible.
The Independence Clubs, it was kind of different because I had been used to going two or three times a week, and that was kind of hard.
That's a 180 from what the whole clubhouse philosophy is, which is working side by side, members and staff. And now we're being told we can't work side by side.
In the beginning, they had pivoted to a totally virtual format. And they had switched all of a sudden when those doors closed to 40 hours of programming a week.
And we started seeing patients at the health group virtually. So it's over the phone and through Zoom calls.
But that in itself also has been difficult to get that technology out to people, because even just meeting up with people to get them the technology, some people don't feel comfortable meeting up with other people right now. So we've had to go to great lengths to make sure that everyone's safe, that we're following every safety protocol put in place by the state, CDC, federal government, all of the above.
It was a difficult time financially because what we were up against with closing the clubhouse doors, we were looking at a $200,000 to $300,000 per month loss. And that's where our revenue really was a hardship, because we couldn't open our doors, at least at first. We had a committee that of members and staff alike that looked at the safety of coming back and opening the doors. But we didn't open our doors till June 22nd. So from March 13th to June 22nd, it was a long time to go without the members. It felt like we were moving back to normal,
but from zero to the mid-80s may sound huge, and it is. It's significant, and I'm still so impressed at what the clubhouse members and staff did. But it's 50% of where we were pre-COVID. And we're a nonprofit, and our revenue comes from our service, which comes from people participating and walking through that front door. And if only half of those people are walking through that front door, we're still in great need of financial help.
And we need to be able to kind of get back to that feeling of thriving again. And I think in order to do that, we're going to need support from donors to be able to help us to build back what we've lost.
Independent Center changes lives. You know, we go from being symptomatic to holding jobs, going to college. It helped us rebuild our lives back. And that person who's left out, they don't have that choice if these doors close.
Without Independent Center, there would be a lot of people who don't have access to care, don't have access to a daily routine, who don't have access to medication. Independent Center helps people do everything that they, you know, haven't been able to do in the past.
And I think if there is a silver lining to COVID, when people got a taste of what it's like to be isolated and what that does to you as a person, I'm hoping that people will remember that feeling when they think about, you know, giving to organizations like Independent Center, that, you know, what they do is going to help people in a meaningful way to not feel like they did.
My team and I got together and we have decided that we are 100% united, that we are never going to close that front door again, that we are going to do whatever it takes to keep the front doors of Independent Center open for our members to have a place to go, to have a place to belong, to have community, and to have connection.
As you saw in the video, it has been quite a year and difficult for the Independent Center. What they have had to do is meet their members where they are. I'd like to bring in Abby Berger now. Abby is the Business Development Manager. Abby, thank you for joining us.
Thanks, Jennifer.
So let's go back to March, and why don't you walk us through all the things that have happened?
Sure. Well, it's certainly been a lot, but I will try. In March, Independent Center had to close its physical spaces to members. Our two residential care facilities had to begin quarantining, and most of our clinical services pivoted to telehealth, which has been very successful. For the clubhouse, we were able to create virtual programming for the members. That includes a virtual clubhouse portal that members can access from anywhere. It has important information about their services. We also created a private Facebook group for members to use and interact with one another. And then we have a full schedule of Zoom meetings that members can participate in when they're not in the physical building. So in July, we began reopening the physical spaces, and right now we're running parallel programs. So we have in-person and virtual programs. And we've been trying just to get back to our pre-COVID attendance and get our services back to our new normal.
You know, Abby, one of the things I've learned from all the times I've visited the Independent Center is that the socialization and the routines are so important to your members trying to manage their mental health. How have your virtual services helped them with that?
Well, I think that they've helped as much as they can. So, you know, virtual services aren't going to ever replace what in-person services could provide. But, you know, we've done our best, and we've tried to meet members where they are and give them the technology to access those virtual supports if they're not able to.
Now, tell us a little bit about the numbers, how many people you used to have come to the clubhouse and how many come there now.
So prior to COVID, we were at about 180 members coming to the clubhouse for an average of 3 hours a day. And right now, we're seeing about 80 people in person for a little bit less time, about 1 to 2 hours. So it's definitely a decrease in the amount of people that we're seeing daily.
So Abby, what happens to the other people who are not coming to the clubhouse? And they used to.
Yeah, I think a lot of people have valid concerns about their health and safety. You know, we have seen there's a huge disparity in the way healthcare is delivered. And that's no different from our members. A lot of them sit at below or right at the federal poverty level. So they don't necessarily have access to a phone, to a computer, to even their own form of transportation. So anytime something's going on in the community that inhibits them from getting to us, it creates a challenge. Our community support staff and our clubhouse staff have done an incredible job of going out into the community and meeting members where they are, which is especially hard when people don't have phones or computers and you don't necessarily know where exactly someone is located.
So Abby, what about finances for the Independence Center? How have they been affected?
Well, you heard a little bit in the film, but we run on a fee-for-service type of funding. So when a member comes in to receive services from us, we are able to bill Medicaid for that time that they spend in our services. For anyone that doesn't have Medicaid, we are able to use our fundraising dollars, which is why we're here tonight, because we don't ever want to turn anyone away for inability to pay. So it's either reimbursement from Medicaid or fundraising dollars. And obviously, if we're not providing the same volume of services, that impacts our funding, which then impacts our ability to keep staff. We went through a pretty difficult time back in July where we had to furlough and eliminate staff positions just to remain financially stable. Right now we're operating on a pretty lean staffing structure. So it's been tough.
Abby, are there any other things during this pandemic that you just didn't see coming?
I definitely don't. I mean, obviously we didn't see the pandemic coming, but we did not really see ourselves going into a virtual type of program delivery. That has been completely new to us. We've really had to build that from the ground up. How do we deliver services virtually or in the hybrid model? How do we continue to be accessible to those that need us? You know, one of the really great things that has happened this year because of that technology is being awarded 2 pretty large grants where we were able to purchase devices and services for those devices to give out to members so that they could get connected to our virtual programming. But it also allows them to connect with their family and friends. I think of myself, I do everything on my phone. I even order my groceries on my phone. So, you know, being able to give that to somebody who has never had that ability it's pretty powerful. So I think it's changed the way we work for the better in a lot of instances, but it's certainly been a challenge.
Abby, we're so grateful to all the people who are watching tonight. How can they help?
I think to be perfectly upfront, we need your financial support more than ever before. We've been hit pretty hard this past year. I'm really proud of the work that's been done, the innovation of the programs, and our ability to work through a crisis. I think, you know, this organization has withstood a lot of challenges this past year, but we need that funding and we need that support from donors like everyone watching tonight to continue our mission and continue our work and in the community. We're also going to be running a fund in need throughout the evening to additionally support those needing technology. So you can actually adopt a phone plan for $25 a month and support a member who needs to stay connected virtually to us, either in a hybrid model or a completely virtual model. We've seen that just be so important to our members this year, and we want to continue to build on that and build out our programming so that it's accessible to everybody.
Thanks, Abby. That certainly sets the stage for why Dancing with the Stars is so important. Right now, let's go over to Board President Ian Watkins.
Good evening, everyone. And to the more than 9,000 of you that are currently viewing this live cast, welcome to tonight's show. Before we get started, I'd like to take a moment to talk about a very important person who's not here with us this evening, and that's Bill French. Bill passed away on Sunday, December 19th, after a short battle with the coronavirus. As many of you know, Bill had a passion for life. Whether talking about his family, his company, or the Independent Center, he always spoke from the heart. His passion and love for life is contagious, and as such, he was a man that never met a stranger. He was passionate about fighting the stigma associated with mental illness, a champion of the mission of the Independent Center, a long-standing member of the board, and a gifted fundraiser and networker who pushed this organization to grow Dancing to what it is today. He is someone that I, along with many others, considered a dear friend. Now, his legacy will continue through his business and the Independent Center, but we're dedicating this year's event to Bill and hope to make him proud with what we're able to achieve at tonight's event to benefit the Independent Center.
My name is Bill French. I am the owner of William French Byers Real Estate Services, which is a firm that I started 36 years ago, coming this next year. Mike is my oldest son. And then I have my other son, John, and John is the person who is a member at Independent Center. In early memories of John, as John was a typical kid growing up in West St. Louis County, on the swim teams, on the soccer teams, eventually went off to college. And unfortunately, that first year of college did not go too well. Things just seemed to be different about John. And of course, it was the onset of mental illness. He went from what you would consider a normal, average kid to completely drawn into the depths of mental illness. And it is a difficult thing for families to really understand and to react to. He came home from college after that first year, and unfortunately things had not worked out, so he could not go back to college. And he began to isolate himself. And then suddenly one day just disappeared. We had no idea where he was. And then the watershed moment came. He went to the quick shop, bought some razor blades, slashed his wrists. And he fortunately took himself to St. Luke's Hospital. And at that point, it became an issue of where do we get care for him? We looked at a lot of different options, and when I say we, it was really more my son and my former wife. Somehow, she arrived at the Independent Center. And Independent Center came out and interviewed John and agreed that he was somebody who was a good candidate for their program. And the strides that he's made over that period of time have been unbelievably good. I know that a lot of people feel a stigma about mental illness. I honestly never felt that way. I have no feelings that there's a stigma to this person. I do know that they become disenfranchised. I know the principle behind Independent Center is restoring lives. In our case, it was saving a life. And then having a life. I can't better express the need to support Independent Center than I can just from my own personal experience this Christmas. I asked my son, John, what he would like for Christmas. He said, give money to Independence Center for me. He didn't want anything. He wanted that money to go to Independence Center. He just loves the people over there. And he told me to mention Paul.
Bill, thank you for everything you've done for this organization. On behalf of the Independence Center Board of Directors, our young professionals, staff, and most importantly, the members, thank you for joining us for an evening of entertaining and inspiring dance performances. We're grateful for the support of our mission, so let's take a moment to recognize tonight's wonderful sponsors. Thank you to all of those. 40 years ago, the Independence Center was founded by a small group of parents, all with adult children suffering with the challenges of mental illness. Tonight, founding director Bob Harvey joins us to share just how the Independence Center got its start here in St. Louis.
Good evening. I'm Bob Harvey, and it is gratifying to be here with you to celebrate the center's 40th anniversary and to review the origins of the center. Now in 1980, at a cocktail reception in the East Room of the White House, I met Susan Hecker, the founding president of the newly formed board of directors of an organization that existed only on paper. An organization with a dream and a drive to create in St. Louis a place, a program, a community designed to improve the lives of people with mental illnesses. And I was hired to bring that dream to life. Now in 1981, with a staff of three and a budget of $100,000 and a clear vision, we rented a small storefront on Laclede, just east of Euclid. Now in that storefront, there was donated merchandise, a cash register, a typewriter, and a hot plate, and a plan. Now, of course, the typewriter became what we call the clerical unit. The hot plate, the kitchen unit. The cash register, the store. Now, having trained at Fountain House in New York City, I understood that work, meaning a purpose, a role, a way of belonging, was, as I wrote, the glue that binds us to society. With the help of a brilliant and creative staff, members, a strong board of directors, and generous supporters in the community, that small storefront grew to become the second largest clubhouse model program in the world. Which is quite a feat, because St. Louis is far from the largest city in the world. Now, during my years at the center, we accomplished much in our efforts to meet the needs of a growing membership. We were the first clubhouse in the Midwest. We created a dynamic transitional employment program, an independent employment program, educational opportunities, an apartment program. We were the first clubhouse to build its own housing, the first to bring a wellness program in-house, the first to create an outpatient clinic of its own, the first to set up a partial hospital service in partnership with a hospital in the community, the first to make itself a clubhouse training base, and the first to operate its own community support program. We were the first to seek and achieve accreditation by CARF, the Commission on Accreditation of Rehabilitation Facilities, and we were accredited by the International Center for Clubhouse Development. We were also the first and only clubhouse model program in the world to take members and staff to a clubhouse conference on a rented Learjet. But that's a story for another time. Now, when I retired, Independent Center had grown from a storefront operation into a comprehensive system of programs and services designed to assist adults with serious and persistent mental illnesses to live and work in the community independently and with dignity. From a storefront with a budget of $100,000 to a nationally recognized and award-winning program with an annual budget of some $5 million and an average daily attendance of over 100 members per day. Now, none of this could have been achieved without you, the center's supporters. And while I may not know you, I know who you are. You are the source of strength that has enabled Independent Center to sustain its mission and to continue to be the precious and critical resource in St. Louis that the founders imagined. Thank you. And thank you for allowing me to be a part of this celebration tonight.
Thank you, Bob, for sharing just how far we've come in 40 years. Now, as we look forward to the next 40 years, we need the Independent Center to continue its vital role supporting people in our community suffering with persistent mental illness. And to help us do that, each year we host this event. There's truly nothing like our Dancing with the St. Louis Stars. So where else will you find community leaders paired with a professional dance partner who rehearse and fundraise for months and then perform to raise funds to support those with mental illness? Now, I'm humbled to know that this year in our Champion of Champions event, 23 past dancers returned to compete again. Each of these dancers have in the past dedicated nearly a year to fundraising on our behalf and have relayed our message to their family and friends. So beyond the money raised, they've helped stop the stigma associated with mental illness. Now it's my honor to introduce you to the dancers that continue to support the Independent Center. Brittany Adams, Jim Brennan, Mark Belander, Jim Castellano, Ron Doherty, Arnold Donald, Chris Hempel, Terry Hodges, Kristen Johnson, Fred Kostecki, Marco Mino, Ed Monser, Team Nichols, Lisa Rogers, Craig Schnook, Dick Shaw, Deandra Smith, Nancy Stout, Michelle Tibbs, Bob Tomasano, Mark Trudeau, Lynn-Ann Vogel, and Tim and Robin Wentworth. Thank you to all these dancers and professional dance instructors that have worked so incredibly hard. Because we don't want to keep you here all night, we've selected the top four fundraisers for tonight's competition. So to get us started with the dancing, I'd like to introduce our MC, Brittany Adams, past dancer, board member, and a member here at the Independent Center. So let's take a moment to hear how Brittany came to be associated with the Independent Center.
My name is Brittany Adams. Picture this, a six-year-old little girl getting molested and sodomized on her sixth birthday by her cousin. Imagine this going on every day until she was 12 years old. Now picture this little girl as a 15-year-old teenager being raped at gunpoint by her best friend. Imagine her realizing she was pregnant with her rapist baby. Now picture this teenager injecting herself with 200 units of insulin and taking over 500 pills because she gave up on life. Picture this teenager pronounced dead at 7:47 p.m. on November 6, 1995. Imagine her in a coma on life support for 3 weeks. I am that teenager. I started hearing voices at the age of 10. My parents would find me holding entire conversations with myself, but they thought I had an overactive imagination as I was an only child. I felt rejected by my parents. Often they would push me away when I wanted a hug or a kiss. My cousin used to tell me that what he was doing to me daily was his way of showing me that he loved me. Psychologically, I was under his spell. I began to look forward to him molesting me. I didn't know that it was wrong. When I started my menstrual cycle and he suddenly stopped molesting me, I felt rejected again. The voices began to grow in their intensity and negativity. My parents thought that if we moved away, that my acting out would stop. At the age of 14, we moved to Las Vegas, Nevada. I started school and quickly found friends. I became increasingly close to two of my male friends. Little did I know that one of those so-called friends would end up raping me at gunpoint in my own home. 2 months later, I found out I was pregnant by my rapist. Mentally, my mind and my world was in a whirlwind that just would not seem to stop. All of this trauma resulted in a complete psychotic break. I tried to commit suicide because I had given up all hope that my life was worth living. My mother told me that she heard the doctor call my time of death, but as he was exiting the room to deliver the bad news, I came back to life. Guess my spirit wasn't ready to die, but I ended up in a coma and I lost the baby. I was on life support because my left lung had collapsed and I couldn't breathe for myself. I was asked why I tried to kill myself, but I kept quiet about what happened to me. I said I could not remember. Over the next 5 years, I continued to be rebellious by acting out what my voices told me to do. I got pregnant and had a daughter at 21. After I had her, my panic attacks and voices got worse. I finally sought the help of a psychiatrist. I was originally diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and an anxiety disorder. The medication was helping me not hear voices or be anxious, but I was sleeping my life away. So I began self-medicating with the street drug methamphetamine. Meth took away my voices, my anxiety, my pain, both physical and mental. It helped me lose weight and stay alert. My use of meth led me to doing criminal things just to get high so I wouldn't have to feel the pain of my life. The criminal acts caught up with me, and I ultimately ended up incarcerated. I received a limited amount of psychiatric help while I was in jail. But the day that I was released, I went out and got high. I was still self-medicating and miserable. I stayed high every day for a year when finally my other criminal acts caught up with me once again. This time I was incarcerated for 17 months. I was 27 years old. It was during this incarceration that I had the epiphany that meth was no good for me. I also realized that I needed professional help to better handle my illnesses and not self-medicate with meth. When I was released, I moved to St. Louis. I finally got approved for SSI, and I ended up moving into a boarding home with 10 other people. It was at this time that I received a letter and brochure. It was the Independent Center reaching out to me. I wasn't doing anything besides sleeping and eating on a daily basis, so I figured that I didn't have anything to lose. I immediately fell in love with the clubhouse. I was so eager to become a member. During enrollment, I had to establish some goals, and I actually thought about my future instead of my past. I started volunteering to do different jobs around the clubhouse. The more engaged I became, the better I started feeling about myself. However, I still had a lot of traumatic life events that I needed help to deal with. The Independent Center got me connected with a good psychiatrist and therapist at Midwest Psychiatry. And I actually found the motivation to go back to school. I have since graduated from Southern New Hampshire University with a bachelor's in psychology. The Clubhouse has been a lifesaver for me. Since becoming a member at the Independent Center, I have quit smoking, graduated college, started working as a peer specialist at BJC Behavioral Health, and I have purchased my first home with the love of my life, who was also a member of the Clubhouse. I have accomplished most of my goals that I established so long ago. I am still in therapy as there are many hurdles for me to overcome. The Clubhouse is helping me to manage the new diabetes diagnosis, yet another obstacle. I am confident that I can deal with this hurdle as long as I have the Independent Center. They are my lifeline. My life has been hard and traumatic. I have been through horrific things, but yet here I am. I am no longer a victim. I am not defined by my past. I am not my illness. So let me tell you who I am. I am confident. I am strong. I am a colleague. I am a member of an elite community. I am a college graduate. I am a best friend. I am someone's girlfriend. I am a woman who has conquered the worst of things that life has thrown at me. But I feel like my life has just begun. I thank God every day for sending me to the Clubhouse, for they have truly saved my life.
Hello, I am so excited to be here live to spend this evening with you. Now, you heard the impact that the Independent Center has had on my life, and we can make that difference tonight for others. Now, let's see our four finalists. Hi, everyone. Congratulations on being our finalists.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Brittany.
Hello.
Jim Brennan, you are leading this pack. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling wonderful, very confident, but I know I'm up against these big corporate types, Brittany, but I could tell you, I am the people's choice. I've got more individual contributions than anybody, and I'm not quitting. I am working hard as we speak to raise more money for this worthy cause in memory of our dear friend, Bill French.
Absolutely. Mark Trudeau, what are you most excited about tonight?
Well, Brittany, first of all, I want to thank you for sharing your very triumphant and uplifting story. Yours is a very powerful one. And frankly, it's one that I've heard similar stories on multiple occasions for other members of the Independent Center. And I always am impressed about kind of the perseverance that you all have as a result of the good work that's done by the Independent Center. And that's one of the reasons why I'm always very excited to be part of the fundraising for all of this, because of the good work that's done for the from the Independent Center on behalf of the members. So again, I know it takes a lot of courage to stand up and talk about your story, but I really want to thank you for that, because it was personally quite moving for me, and one that I think gives a lot of us motivation to do as much as we can to help the members of the Independent Center. So thank you very much for that.
You're quite welcome. Now, Ed Monser, who do you have over at your watch party?
Well, I'm lucky that I have my close family. I have my granddaughter, Celeste, my favorite niece, Hayden, a couple dogs, and folks like that. But just like everybody else, Brittany, you know, what your story connects to all of us. Mental illness is not an isolated issue in our society. It's part of almost every family. And This year with COVID and the isolation that comes with that and all those challenges, when I and everybody else on this team was asked to help, it was an easy yes. Now, I was labeled a corporate type already. I'm a retired corporate type, so I'm kind of an independent contractor now, but I'm still out there trying to help any way I can, and I am delighted to be here tonight and delighted to ask folks to continue to donate to support this gem of St. Louis. So I'm delighted to be with you, especially, Brittany. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Lisa and Allie Nichols, are you ready to get tonight started?
We yes. are ready, Brittany.
I'm ready, Brittany.
Let's go.
Say, let's go.
Hit it.
Yay.
Let's hit it, Brittany.
Thank you, finalists. We will be checking back with you throughout the evening. Now, let's take a look at our leaderboard as we start off our evening. And we did not forget about our other dancers who have worked hard to fundraise. All dancers that are not in the top four are able to select who they would like to cheerlead for and assign their votes and dollars. We will make announcements throughout the evening and assign those votes. I want to remind everyone in the audience that you can determine tonight's winners. Awards will be given to Dance Champion and Dancing MVP. The Dance Champion Award is given to the couple that raises the most votes overall, advance votes plus votes tonight. The MVP Award, our top award, is given to the couple who raised the most combining votes and sponsorship. Now, after each couple dances, we will ask you to voice your opinion on which act is your favorite by purchasing votes. One vote is $10, and there's no limit to how many votes you can purchase. Now, many of you have already voted, but if you haven't, please visit the link or scan the QR code on the screen with your mobile device. You will see our four finalists listed. To vote, click and submit the amount of votes you would like to purchase. It's that easy. And at the end of the night, if you have unpaid votes, you will receive a text message to complete the payment process. All donations from voting are tax deductible. And whether you vote from your desktop, laptop, or phone, you still will receive a tax receipt. Remember, you can vote as many times as you would like at any point in the evening. Centene Charitable Foundation is sponsoring our live leaderboard. Throughout the evening, you'll be able to see how close we are to reaching our goal of 700,000 and where each dancer stands. Now, in the event of a tie, the crowd will be given another opportunity to vote within a 5-minute period. The couple with the most votes after 5 minutes will be the winner. All right, let's meet our finalists, starting with Ed Monser. It is my pleasure to introduce Ed Monser, a pillar in our community, and his partner, Angie Brooks, from St. Louis Dancing Classrooms. Ed, while we watch the clip of your video, tell us why people should vote for you.
It is my pleasure. And I can tell you, this is the very first time I danced. When I said yes to support this event, I don't know what I was thinking, but I got very lucky to be able to dance with Angie Brooks. And as you can see, she used a trick. She said, let's start out dancing very clumsily. And then when we switch to you dancing better, people will think you actually do know how to dance. So it was a good trick. The fun thing is I've just kept dancing for the 5 years since then. But really what I want you to do is think about people doing this and having some courage but really it's just a symbol of the courage of the people that are in the clubhouse, a symbol of the courage that the people have at the Independence Center. All of us that are dancing, all of us that are helping to raise funds, trying to motivate donors. The donors are really the stars here tonight, because the money that you give enables the best work in the world to be done in our community. And it is work that is done here in St. Louis for the citizens and the residents of St. Louis. It is really a gem. So hopefully all of you will continue to call in, to wire in, to mail in, and to support, and to let people like me and the rest of us to have some fun as we do it. And I really appreciate it. So thank you. What a finish. Thank you, Brittany.
You're welcome. Thank you. That was awesome.
It's fun to watch.
So good to hear you came back to the Independence Center to support it. Now let's take a look at that leaderboard and assign those cheerleading votes.
Okay. Holy cow. Thank you.
Thank you. Awesome.
Thank you, everybody.
Now, let's check out a story from our member, Lisa Clay, to hear about how Independence Center has helped her become more independent.
Welcome to Dancing with the St. Louis Stars this evening. My name is Lisa Clay, and I'm a member at the Independence Center. I became a member in June of 2017, and my life drastically changed for the better. Before coming in, I was in a dark place in my life. I was doing nothing but eating and sleeping. This was my life for 24 straight years. I didn't see anything in life or me before I came to Independence Center. I was introduced to a place that brought my life into existence. Things really started to change as I attended regularly at the clubhouse. When I first started, I was going to the clubhouse for the Weight Watcher class. But getting involved in the unit and the work of the day, things changed. I was not aware that I had skills and potential, but the clubhouse showed me that I did. It's amazing when someone tells you you are doing good at something. Coming to the clubhouse boosted my confidence, and it has given me purpose in life. It gave me something to do rather than sleep and eat. I built a routine at the clubhouse, and it gave me skills that I can use in the real world, at work and in the community. I'm doing things now I didn't think I could ever achieve.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Claire Kellett of KMOV News 4, and I am thrilled that Brittany has stepped up to the plate to be this year's MC. She is all around amazing, and she certainly doesn't back down from a challenge. As many of you know, I have been involved with Dancing with the St. Louis Stars as a past dancer and the MC for now, well, let's just say probably too many years to count. I did take a little break this year as my husband and I are expecting our second child in just a matter of weeks now. I am really glad that this year's event could continue virtually and that all of you are taking part tonight. And to say that 2020 has been tough on all of us would be an understatement. At the same time, though, it has certainly helped shed some light on what people with severe mental illness face each and every day. And given those very real challenges facing the members, I hope you all will consider donating to Independence Center. Now, honestly, I'm not the best at asking for money, but I know that the stories you will hear tonight and the videos you will watch will really tug at your heartstrings, and it will motivate you to get out that credit card. And I truly mean it when I say your donation is more important than ever. So pour yourself a drink, maybe have one for me, and donate, donate, donate. We can't say that enough. Thank you all for attending, and I hope you have a wonderful evening.
It's awesome to see what a difference Independence Center is making for Lisa and all that she has accomplished. You are right, Claire. This year has been incredibly tough, mentally, emotionally, and most importantly, financially. Thank you for your continued support. And all the best to your ever-expanding family. Now, let's meet Mark Trudeau, CEO of Mallinckrodt Pharmaceuticals, and his partner, Lucy Fitzgerald from Just Dancing. Now, Mark, while we watch your video, tell us why people should vote for you.
Well, it's going to be interesting to watch this video again. As we know, one of the things that is always problematic about the internet is once something gets on the internet, it never goes away. And let's just say that this video has come back to haunt me many times. As a number of folks have watched this over the years and commented on how well I've impersonated a robot as opposed to a dancer. But I remember thinking that thank God I had Lucy as my partner because Lucy could make just about anybody look good. And she certainly had her work cut out when she was making. But we were very pleased to be able to win the event. And Lucy was fantastic. And, you know, this is an event that I was so happy to be part of. I'd been part of it as a supporter for a number of other years. And I really didn't have much of a chance not to become a dancer because I've had a personal engagement and relationship with Bill French for a number of years and also Ian Watkins. And so, you know, this is something that I've personally felt close to because of those two individuals, but also like many of us, we all have family members that, you know, or we typically have family members that experience mental health issues, and my family is no different. And so this was very personal for me as well. And it was just a really thrilling evening and really happy to be part of it. Look, no matter how you donate, who you vote for, it really doesn't matter. At the end of the day, I think what's most important is that we support the Independence Center and the very noble cause that the Independence Center represents and the very good work that they do for all of the members. And we've heard some of these very powerful stories tonight. Those stories are endless, and frankly, we can't do enough to support this great organization. So it's been a pleasure to be part of this, and thanks very much for inviting me to come back and be part of the virtual event this evening.
Thank you, Mark. Mark, I have to be honest with you. This was one of my favorite performances over the years. Now let's take a look at that leaderboard and assign those cheerleading votes. And now, a word from our leaderboard sponsor and a loyal supporter, Centene Charitable Foundation. We'll hear from our member, Daryl, who has been a member for a short time, but has already made tremendous strides in his mental health recovery.
Good evening. I am Ted Pinkos, Vice President, Finance and Accounting at Centene Corporation and Independence Center board member. Thank you all for joining us tonight. The Centene Charitable Foundation has partnered with Independence Center since 2010 in support of its mission to provide services for those with severe and persistent mental illness. We are delighted to sponsor this year's Dancing with the St. Louis Stars event and hope you will enjoy the evening. Please remember to vote early and often for your favorite dancer. Thank you.
Hi. My name is Daryl. I am a member at Independence Center and have been coming to the center for 2 years. I came here looking for resources and for people that are like me. I wanted to find other adults I could relate to and work with. By coming to IC, I've been able to find support with my anxiety and learning how to cope with my mental health. I found support from people who generally understand mental health and all come together with different stories. Everyone is working on similar goals of breaking down stigma and working toward their highest potential. This year, I have been challenged by COVID-19 after it halted IC services temporarily. It was a major initial shock that we were in a pandemic and that we were all isolated. COVID changed everything. My supports, my connection to IC, and my entire daily structure. It has been a daily struggle wondering when things will be back to normal. This year, I've been focusing on staying connected to the clubhouse and using the new resources that have been created in response to COVID. I have been coming to the center as much as I can to create a new normal and a new structure for me. One of my greatest achievements in all of this is going to work. So starting work at Wattlaw has been positive and really helped have a structure, help me have a structure again. Going to work is really exciting for me and gives me purpose and new experiences each day. I feel important and I feel needed in my job. Having this opportunity has given me hope again and a purpose. I'm surrounded by people who care about me and want to see me succeed. I think it is important that everyone watching tonight knows to never give up. Waking up is just half the battle. As we work through all the new stressors of COVID, listen to your doctors and remember that you can learn from anyone. Thank you for watching tonight. There are so many people like me that benefit from being a member at the Independence Center, and your donations help ensure that our doors remain open. Please consider donating to Independence Center tonight by voting for your favorite dancer. Enjoy the evening.
Hello, my name is Sarah Yang Bosco. I am a board member of Independence Center, a nonprofit in St. Louis, Missouri, dedicated to serving adults with severe and persistent mental illness. Independence Center is accredited through the Commission of Accreditation of Rehabilitation Facilities and Clubhouse International. Thank you for joining us for the selection of the Champion of Champions at the Dancing with the St. Louis Stars Gala. I hope you are reliving and enjoying the performances as much as I am. I joined the board in 2018. Prior to joining Independence Center, I did not know very much about mental health or mental health care. Shortly after arriving to St. Louis in 2016, I was taken on a tour of the clubhouse led by a couple of the members. The welcome I received was absolutely heartwarming. Since becoming a board member, I have learned about the holistic approach to assisting those with mental health challenges through the provision of community, a place where social networks and relationships provide friendship, support, hope, and love, purpose by providing meaningful daily activities and achieving independence, income, and resources to participate in society, a focus on health, by offering healthy and informed choices that support physical and emotional well-being, and home in the form of affordable, stable, and safe places to live. These are all basic elements needed for anyone to gain confidence, reinstill one's self-worth, and become a productive member of society, goals we all have. The past few months, the need for mental health has been made more acute with the quarantine and isolation that has become necessary responses to the pandemic crisis. That is why the mission of Independence Center has become even more critical. Your participation in tonight's gala strongly demonstrates the recognition of this need. So vote. For once I can say vote early and vote often for your favorite team, or consider otherwise making a donation to Independence Center. And thank you for all you do for Independence Center and for our community.
Thank you, Daryl and Sarah, for sharing with us. As we said at the beginning of the show, some incredible people have rallied around us to keep us going. One in particular is Ryan Hanlon and his team at Route 3. They put together our opening film and re-edited the tribute to Bill French as a donation to the center this year because it was outside of our budget. We are incredibly thankful for those who continue to support us and hope that you all will continue to support our mission long after tonight. Here's a word from Ryan.
For almost 10 years now, I have this job where I ask people a really important question. It's the last question I ask people in my interviews. Why do you do what you do? I've never really asked myself that question. But I guess the best answer I would have is that I love my job. I love the people I work with. I love the people I get to work for. I cheer for these people. I cheer for these organizations. I advocate for them. And every day that I get to hop in the car with my team and go make a film, I just feel immensely blessed and hope I get to do this forever.
Now, let's get back into it with Team Nichols, Allie and her mom, Lisa, CEO of Technology Partners. Allie's partner is Mike McAllister from Dan's Pizzazz. Allie,
yes.
You have been quite a crowd pleaser in the past. What is your favorite part of dancing? And you and your mom make quite a team, don't you?
Yeah. Well, I asked mom. She's I told mom she'd be able to help me or a team.
Can I help you?
Yeah, help me and a team.
We're good team.
Yeah,
we're BFFs.
We'd be a good team. BFF. She's my best mom. Riggedy, me here.
Oh, she's gonna. She's going to ask us some other questions. But look, there you are. There you and Mike are dancing. So much fun. What was the name of the song, Allie?
Come Alive.
Come Alive from The Greatest Showman. So much fun, wasn't it?
Huh?
Is Mike a good dance? Is he a good dance teacher?
Really?
Yeah. Is Mike
what did you guys love?
I love Come Alive, Bear Eyes. I love dancing. I mean, I got moves and then
you got moves.
Trying to focus and then doing a dancing.
She tries to focus and she just loves doing moves, Brittany.
That's your teacher, Mike.
Yes.
Would you certainly show it?
Yeah, thank you, Brittany.
You look amazing in your performance.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is my purple dress, so.
That's your purple dress? Do you remember who made your dress?
Yep. A guy.
Di? Yeah, Di Swain. She's an amazing dressmaker. Yep. If anyone needs a dance dress or a wedding dress, really, she does a lot of wedding dresses.
Mm-hmm. Wait, I'm watching now. Are you coming?
Mm-hmm. Very quick. There she is. There's Brittany.
Hi, Allie and Lisa. Outstanding job. Now let's assign your cheerleading points and see the new leaderboard.
What was it?
Oh, my goodness.
What is it?
And now, let's hear from some longtime supporters.
Greetings from the Reverend Dr. Blythe Denham Kiefer and Dr. Peter Strickler Kiefer. As Presbyterian pastor and pediatrician with longstanding community ties in St. Louis before moving to Springfield, Illinois, we encourage you to support the unique and essential mission of the Independent Center.
We are delighted to join with you tonight virtually, since Blythe and I have attended each one of these Dancing with the Stars events since its inception, long ago when I chaired the board and when we were planning for a new clubhouse. You know, 40 years ago, serious and persistent mental illness in our extended family led Susan and George Hecker to join with other founders in establishing Independence Center.
The story of the Hecker's journey of hope and resilience, which I shared in a sermon years ago in a church in St. Louis, led to the invitation to Peter to serve on the Independence Center board, along with chairing the board during the decision to create the new clubhouse. Peter led the capital campaign to make that vision a reality, thanks to the generosity of so many St. Louisians.
My mother Martha's noble perseverance with psychotic depression and the successful lives of so many of our members continue to inspire life and me to support the innovative social, medical, educational, and vocational programs at our internationally acclaimed clubhouse.
The Independence Center Flower Shop is named for Peter's mother, Martha. Please consider offering your financial support tonight, and consider a phone a ma option that will enable a member to receive a telehealth conference or the virtual programming in the Independence Center, which is so crucial as we deal with this challenging solitude during this pandemic.
And please vote again and again for your favorite dancer.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Blythe and Dr. Peter Kiefer. So great to have you with us. Now let's meet our last finalists, Jim Brennan and his partner, Lucy Fitzgerald from Just Dancing. Jim, what can you tell people to maintain your lead tonight?
Brittany, I gotta tell you, I'm so grateful for all my family, friends, employees, especially our home building industry that have dug deep and written some big checks. I'm gonna continue to, I've got a whole bunch of people upstairs and hopefully they're gonna still continue to vote. But I'm doing this in honor of my good friend, Bill French. 5 years ago, he asked me to support and dance him and Jim Castellano, the Independence Center. And I was very moved when I saw the video that you replayed of Bill this evening. He was just a great, great individual. In fact, in early December, I called Bill and asked him to write a check for the Independence Center. Little did I know he was in the ICU at MOBAP. He answered the phone and he promised me that he was gonna pledge. And I was so touched today when Debbie wrote a check to support. And I'm doing my best to raise the most. As I said, I'm up against some stiff competition. And I know they're trying to catch me, and I say, catch me if you can. Because the more I raise, the more they're gonna try to raise, and the real winner is the Independence Center. It's such a worthy cause. I was touched by your story this evening, Brittany, and you know, I know I think we danced the same year 4 years ago, and you did a great job. And you're living proof of the success of Independence Center. So you can see here, Lucy Fitzgerald, she has won I don't know how many times in a row. I hope you're watching Lucy instead of me. I'm a home builder. In fact, today I got an email from one of my high school friends, and she said, why in the world didn't you dance when you were in high school? I was always up against the wall at Mary Magdalene's Teen Town, and I got to do this right now. So you got to vote for Brennan, James Brennan. Otherwise, there'll be big trouble.
Great performance by Jim, and great job raising so much money thus far. Let's revisit the leaderboard and see if there are any cheerleading points to assign. Thank you, Jim. And now is your last chance to cast your vote for your favorite couple.
The votes will soon be tallied, so please vote now by scanning the QR code. I'd like to introduce one final member. Let's hear from Tricia Page.
Hello, my name is Tricia Page. I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder at the age of 15. For much of the next 20 years, I experienced instability in employment and university endeavors, and most importantly, in my personal relationships. At the age of 35, after a particularly frightening onset of symptoms, my two sisters assumed legal guardianship. I lost the freedom to make decisions for my own life and was confronted with a future locked away in an institutional system focused on symptom management and not the healthy development of the whole human person. I was whisked away to live in nursing homes for 2 years, one of which was a 5-hour drive for my family. Those years helped me achieve a minimal level of mental stability, and I saw little hope for change, the kind of change that inspires one in hope for happiness through independent pursuit of dreams and desires. Through the love of my family and the love of people I did not yet know, my life turned from stagnation to opportunity when I was blessed to join the Independent Center as a member. This brought me a shaft of light into a shadowy future. On August 10th, 2018, my application to live in Independent Center housing was accepted, and I moved into the residential care facility called Newstead Place in the Central West End. I live there today in my own studio apartment, to which I hold the key. The accounting department assists me in managing my government benefits, and an on-site nurse and traveling caseworker help to coordinate my health care. Through IC Health Group, my psychiatric care is addressed by caring, qualified professionals who meet with me as often as I need. The Independent Center put a roof over my head, food in my belly, and the freedom to once again begin making my own choices. Because Newstead Place is in a walkable neighborhood, I'm able to attend daily mass and be a parishioner at the Cathedral Basilica of St. Louis. I participate in Bible studies, prayer groups, and sing in the cathedral choir. This is the single most valued thing the Independent Center has offered me, religious freedom. The Independent Center has also supported my return to the workforce through temporary jobs and my return to university level study through the Bear Grant. It is important to note that in 5 years' time, I have gone from living in a nursing home on a locked hallway to working on a BA in theology and a goal to move into my own apartment, to once again begin to manage my own resources. My brother-in-law likens mental illness to a cross, and the Independent Center to Simon of Cyrene, who helped Jesus to carry his cross. Without the Independent Center caring for my needs, I would still be living in a locked facility with no hope for a future. There are many, many people who are full of potential and who are unjustly locked away from our society. The Independent Center needs your help to bring their lives and stories into the light. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy the evening.
Thank you, Tricia, for your kind words. And I'm glad that you shared your story. So now we are going to start announcing the winners of this evening. Now, the dance champion is the dancer that raised the most.
Stand by. We are tabulating the results, please. are all ready.
Now, the dance champion is the dancer that raised the most votes overall in advance and tonight without the added cheerleading dollars. And the dance champion of the 12th annual Dancing with the St. Louis Stars raising $130,060 is Jim Brennan.
Thank you, Brittany. I've got a lot of generous friends and family.
Thank you, Jimmy. Congratulations.
Thank you. I am so grateful. I've got so many people to thank. As I said, I'm the people's choice. I got to start by thanking my dear wife of 43 years, Rose, and also my son, Patrick, who's helped me send out over 500 emails. I made well over 100 calls, and people actually took my calls and wrote the generous checks. And I would like to also say, had it not been for Bill French, I would not have had the success that I've had. So I want to dedicate this to Bill.
Okay, well, thank you so much. Congratulations once again. And our final award is the MVP winner, the dancer that raised the most with sponsorships, votes, and cheerleader support, and the MVP of the 12th annual Dancing with the St. Louis Stars, raising an overall $222,540, is none other than Jim Brennan. Let's give them a tremendous round of applause that they can hear at their home.
Thank you, Brittany. As I said, I'm the luckiest guy around. I'm overwhelmed by the support for the Independence Center. And the Independence Center is the real winner here tonight. I want to thank my fellow competitors, Mark, Lisa, and Abby, and Ed. I look at this as a combined team effort with all 20 plus dancers that have been calling their friends, family to raise money. Who would think in COVID-19, we've raised more money tonight, all of it going directly to the bottom line for the Independence Center. We didn't have a nice meal at the Ritz, but we had a great meal here by my brother Tim at Cravings Restaurant. And I know there's people upstairs. I'm not going to tell you how many, but... I could hear them up there celebrating now. So I want to thank all my dear friends, family, employees, especially our home building industry, which really rose to the occasion and supported this worthy cause. So thank you from the bottom of my heart.
We thank you, Jim. Congratulations once again. And wow, look what you were all able to accomplish tonight. We are humbled by your generosity. It's been a pleasure hosting, and thank you for letting me be a part of this wonderful event with you.
Congratulations to all our winners, and Brittany, a fine job emceeing. Claire and I best be careful with you around. To all our donors, your support is so appreciated, and you know it'll make a difference in the lives of people who need it. We also want to acknowledge all our sponsors, and there are quite a few of them, so keep your eyes on the screen. We just could not do this without them, especially this year. It's been more of a challenge than in years past. And we want to thank everybody who made tonight possible. The dancers, the members, supporters, and those of you at home watching. Our donation site will remain up for people who couldn't be with us tonight. And just a reminder, you can catch this program on the website of the Independence Center and also on Facebook. And you can continue to support our dancers at the address on your screen. Good night, everybody, and thank you so much.